Should we go?
Let's do it.
Do you have the music to do the thing over?
I don't.
Should we just wing
it? Yeah.
Okay. Boom. 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 Boom.
I'm Greta.
I'm Dodie.
I'm Martin.
And I'm Orla.
And this is Sunday with Fizz.
Hello, and welcome to the Sunday with Fizz podcast. We are four friends who started a band, and we're on the lookout for the secret to life.
This is our podcast celebrating each song release, going a little bit more in depth and behind the scenes of creating it.
A note from the future!
Since recording this episode, we have pushed back the release date of our album to October 27th, and our UK and Ireland tour will now be in February 2024. You can read all about it on our Instagram, but long story short, we've had too much on our plate and we thought it would be good to slow everything down. Hence the long gap between the last episode and this one. Thankfully, you FIZZ have been very kind about it and we are very, very grateful for your patience. Thank you.
Okay, back to the past.
That's not like a part.
The past. The past.
This week, we released our saddest, softest single. It's called You, Me, Lonely.
If it was what it was, it is what it is. It won't ever be what I want it to be. But I'd be lying if I told you I'm not.
This is your song, Dodie, on the album.
My moment.
I love the song so much.
Me too.
It's so sad.
It is so sad. I like saying on stage, it's so sad. We even say that's so sad in the song. I remember writing it so distinctly. Can you remember when it was going to be called Is?
Is?
Do you remember that?
Oh yeah, no. Is.
There's like an old voice note called Is. There's like a whole new verse as well.
Wow, wow, do you not so remember weird. That?
How, what was the lyric with Is in it?
Oh, it was. It is what it is. Yeah, no, I do remember that. I think I was obsessed with like wanting a song like, what's that beat or something? Because.
Oh, yeah.
I wanted a song that's like a word.
There was a time where I think we wanted the album track list to spell out a sentence. So that's why we wanted to write a song called Is. I think we were like, Strawberry Jam is the secret to life. Oh, so we were like, let's write a song called Is. But it never came to be. I think we got so far along the way. It was obviously going to be You, Me, Lonely.
Dad, sum up the song in three words.
Okay. You know what I'm going to say. You, me, Lonely. No.
It's too easy.
I would say...
is that your buffering noise?
Hold on, I'm thinking. Oh, God, I don't know. There's something quite accepting about it.
Can you hear that?
Yeah, let's wait for that, I reckon.
Let me think about my three words.
How long it's going to be, maybe?
Can't wait for this.
Hello? Sorry, you're just recording something here. Do you know how long you'll be blowing?
How long you'll be blowing?
I don't know what else to fucking call it.
Do you know how long you'll be blowing?
Do you know how long you'll be blowing?
What was I going to say? Like...
I loved it. I was here for it.
Do you know how long you'll be blowing?
Do you know how long you're going to be blowing?
How long are you going to be blowing?
I would sum up the song in three words.
Let me think. There's something kind of... I think whoever is singing it is accepting of it.
I think
you're singing it. I don't know if you realise, you are the one singing the song.
I mean, the
Your name
voice.
Is Dodie, you're in a band called Fizz.
I mean, like the voice of where the song comes from. Because sometimes we sing songs and we're like, that's not us, you know? Like, I think accepting.
I do think this song is like the most real.
Yeah. Accepting real me.
Cute.
Love it. Yeah. Great. What is your favorite lyric in this song?
I think when we were writing it, we were in LA, and this is probably one of maybe three or four songs that we'd written prior to going down to Middle Farm.
Is it like my favorite way to just exist or something?
Well, the only way I know how to exist.
I think there was some stuff happening. I think in your 20s, you sort of, I don't know, you sort of realized that, like, maybe the, like, love you've accepted, or, like, your version of what love is for so much of your life, it doesn't align with your life anymore. And I think there's, like, a grief in that. And I think that's what the song's about, isn't it? It's like...
You know it's not right.
You know it's not right, yeah. And there's, like, a necessary step forward to, like, move away from that time in your life. But it's really hard. And I think a lyric that summarizes that really well in the song is... I love you. I need to. What am I without you? Is, like... Oh, so painful.
I need to. What am I?
Because especially I think if you're someone who feels very defined by your partner or the way that you love someone, and realizing that that's not who you are anymore, do you, like, stay with something that's really comfortable and familiar, or do you be brave and step aside and let that part of your life go? It's just, I don't know, it just summarizes things really well for me.
I'm pretty sick as well.
If it was what it was, it is what it is, it won't ever be what I want it to be.
So nice.
Yeah, it's like, you know it's not right, but that doesn't make it not sad.
Yeah.
That's kind of the feeling I get. It's like accepting. I also think the lyric about thinking of the kids you'll never have hits me in the damn gut.
Oh my God, yeah. And then the one before that about the grey hair, counting the grey hairs on your head. I remember writing that, I just burst in tears. Do you remember?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah, I think just those, like, really concrete things really always get me in a song. Like, I think the chorus lyrics are like a gut punch, but I think when it's something like that grounded in something, like, so real that you think about, that's what really gets me.
Yeah, the grey hairline, like, I feel like we don't go in depth. You don't need to say what it means. Like, I'm counting the grey hairs on your head and I got scared. You know what that means. Like, you don't have to go in depth about, like, I'll never see you get old. But it's like, oh my God, this is the future. Like, one day all of your hair will be grey and I won't be there to see it.
But also, like your hair's going grey and I've wasted my whole life up to this point.
Oh,
you know what
shit.
I mean?
That's
what I feel when I hear that lyric.
Wow.
So I've already wasted time. Look, you're getting grey.
Whoa, I never thought about it that way.
Does, because this is kind of your moment on the album. What does this song mean to you?
It's a topic that I think I struggle with a lot in my life. I feel like I think about soulmates a lot, and I think about, like, life partners a lot, and, like, the people who you get so close to, and how you feel like the truth is that they'll be there forever, and then the idea that they won't be and they'll turn into a ghost of some kind is just, like, the worst feeling in the whole world. And yet you are in this kind of liminal space because you know it has to end and it is going to, but you can't bear the thought of that either, and you're just sort of, like, waiting for the end. That's what this song means to me. It's kind of like, it's like juggling with your subconscious and the truth, but also, like, still enjoying the comfort while you still can. Do you know what? I'm always afraid that this song, whenever we play it live, it will, like, really bring it down. I think whenever you play a festival set or, like, a show, you're like, gotta keep up with the bangers. But then, like, I think this song, when we play it, is such a welcome breather. I remember at Latitude, I made everyone do a big breath and then we all listen together. And you can really tell people are listening, I think. Yeah.
I think it helps that there's, like, just the harmony, isn't it? I feel like throughout, like, the whole album, the, like, four harmonies pretty much on every song really ties everything together. It's one thing in, like, High and Brighton where it's, like, this big Beach Boysy thing, but I think it does showcase that in a way that none of the other songs do.
True.
We don't have to make loads of noise and have, like, 200 layers of instrumentation, but we want to.
Yeah. I think arranging this was really fun. Because I think when you start getting into, like, four-part harmony stuff, it gets a little, for me, I get a bit like, the formula gets a little bit skewed. But I think this was really fun and satisfying, the harmony.
Yeah, so nice. That was really nice, that note.
And actually recording it was so fun. We were in Middle Farm, obviously, in the live room, and I think it was really late. It was like midnight or something.
Pete gone to bed.
Pete had gone to bed and Soren, who assistant engineered the whole album and has sang on As Good As It Gets, and she was the voice on A New Phase Awaits You. She engineered and like produced this track, I would say, and she played bass and just did like a couple takes of it until it felt right. I was fucking baked.
You were so baked. But it really helped you. I remember like you were getting all giggly and I was getting all pissy about it. I was like, Greg, concentrate. And
I kept laughing looking at you, Greg, because you'd like shut your eyes and it was almost as if you really truly believed that you just were Dodie.
Yeah.
And you
you had like one earphone off, one leg up, your hair was all ruffled, your eyes were closed, and you were like, I'd be lying if I... It was so careful. But if you listen to it, man, is that in sync. Like, crazy. Yeah.
I so desperately wanted to be as like close to you as possible emotionally and singing.
Literally the lip smack and everything, like all of it is just
I really just like visualized that I had your mouth in that bit.
I'd be lying if I...
Yeah, there's like one harmony in it that I do with Orla. I remember when we were arranging it, we were like, is that too weird? We're really close. It's like in the last phrase, and without you.
Yeah.
We're like literally a semitone apart. And normally I would be like, no. But for this song, I'm like, ugh.
I really enjoy my notes in the chorus.
Good.
I feel like generally speaking on the album, in fact, like I think most of the songs, especially when we play live, like me and Orla normally sing in octaves. So yeah. I'll sing the lower octave, you sing the higher octave, and then you guys sort of take a third and a fifth loosely. Obviously it like jiggles about a bit. But on this one, I'm doing quite weird notes quite consistently and I really enjoy it.
I have a question for Orla.
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 Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite moment in this song, like sound-wise, sonically?
Well, I kind of have two. I just love how the guitar sounds. That's not a specific moment, but it's Pete's very old and very dusty nylon string that's like quite challenging to play, because like a nylon string has got that like weirdly wide neck, so it kind of is like not the easiest play. I feel like that guitar looks at you and is like, you want to play me? Like, you're gonna have to really work for this.
Put your fingers on my neck.
But I kind of whoa.
Put your fingers on my neck.
Whoa!
Yeah, that's what the guitar said to me in that moment. Put your fingers on my neck. Yeah, but I also just love how the drums sound. They remind me of, so when they come in the second verse, they got that little tiny Andy Schoaf, tiny little snare feeling that I really love.
Mm. I also love Soren's bam, 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 bam.
Yeah, when she added that, I was like, happy.
Nice.
Awesome. Cool.
And there's some really like cheeky piano things.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Just like very like
when you went into the studio and Pete was like, can you just add some keys on it? Literally every single thing you added, I was like, keep it all in. I love it so much.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah.
I really like Matt's drums at the end as well. I guess pretty big.
Yeah.
With that like kick. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think there were two kick mics on it when we initially recorded it, and one of them was so boomy. I think we just must have muted it in the end.
Really? Yeah.
Yeah, it was like.
Wow.
Sounds like your bum.
What's your favorite part, Dodie?
I love the ending. I really love how it builds. I think it feels so panicked to me whenever I sing it. It's almost like truth is building, the end is building, and you can't stop it, but you're still like singing the same thing just in case. I always get quite emotional because I feel like we rise, the song rises, there's like that pounding kick and then everything's scraped away and it's just this like lonely, ghostly ending.
It feels like cyclical thinking when you can't like escape the truth anymore. It's like there in front of you, blindingly obvious all the time.
Whoa, so
spiraling.
Yeah, I'm chronically afraid of the world.
You said
and
that
my
the
loved
other day.
Ones. My relationships.
My relationships.
Real album too. Goldmine that.
Yeah.
I also think testament to you, Gret, on just becoming Dodes, because when we went to arrange this for live. I just thought that was Dodie at the end doing that singing part. Like, we were all even saying, like, oh, I think when we were mixing it, Matt, like, who was Dodie. Mixing it, I was like, can we bring up that stem of Dodie singing at the end? And I just didn't realize it was you.
Greta, you're probably the best of all of us at, like, pretending to be someone else when you sing.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean?
Mm.
Do an impression of Orla singing.
No.
That's pretty spot on, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
So good.
Okay, this is a tangent, but Greta, can you please sing You, Me, Lonely in that, like, old woman voice that you do.
You, I think she might need to be higher.
It was what it was, it is what it is, it won't ever be what I want it to be.
Where do you go?
Yeah. I don't know.
Like, I love who you become, like, your, like, whole face and everything. Yeah, I imagine you as, like, this, like, Pixar grandma, like, in the mountains of, like, I don't know, northern Italy somewhere.
Yeah.
And you just, like, open a window and just, you might have a cigarette in a hand. Yeah. So good.
Okay, well, don't know about you guys, but it's kind of feeling a little too loud in here, isn't it, Greta?
Fair enough. Fair enough.
Yeah, maybe we should move on to something a bit more gentle.
Like that, wouldn't you, you quiet bitch?
You so uncalled for.
You know what? I actually loved it because you whispered it in my ear. It was delicious. In some of your, you like.
Jokes on you.
Jokes on you. I got tingles. Okay. Some of you may not like this next part of today's episode, and that's understandable. But if you do like soft, sweet sounds to tickle your ears and hopefully send shivers up your spine, then listen closely as we play You, Me, ASMR. Welcome to the Fizz ASMR session. What is ASMR, you ask? A feeling for well-being combined with a tingling sensation in the scalp and down the back of the neck, as experienced by some people in response to a specific gentle stimulus, often a particular sound.
Nice.
We would love to walk you to the Logic Project for You, Me, Lonely. So here is a stem store from Dodie. We also have you
so frozen. Oh, God. What happened?
And that's about it for today's episode. Thank you so much for tuning in, everybody.
A friendly reminder that our UK tour tickets are still on sale, so please come if you want to hear all of these absolute bangers live.
You can sign up to our mailing list.
Mailing list!
On yourfavebandfizz.com and find all of our socials there. Send us a message, come say hi, get involved.
Join us next time as we try to discover
the secret to life.